Heidi, you taught me this song in the toilets, and I think it's very appropriate for you and Harsh.
We can zoom in on that.
No, no, you can zoom in. Tujhe dekha to ye jana sanam, kya hota hai diwana sanam, ab yahan se kahan jaye hum.
Honesty, I think that's the first thing that describes Aditi, and just sincerity, you know, I think that's really important in someone who you want to lead your entire life with, that she comes across exactly as the person that she really is. I've never known her to project anything that she's not or project a situation that's not, and that means a lot to me. And that kind of sincerity, integrity and just pure class honesty is the aspect of hers that I'm most in admiration of.
Harsh is the kind of person who pushes me to be the best that I can be. Everything that I have done ever since I've met him has been largely influenced by his inputs in every aspect of my life. He's been an amazing influence, and as a companion, that is something which does hold him in very high regard in my eyes. Harsh knew that I wanted to be formally proposed, and he was always like, no, I'm not going to go down on one knee. But it did happen, and it happened as a total surprise.
I must begin by clarifying that I'm the party in the relationship who's always accused of being the unromantic one. But in my defense, it has to be said that when I do want to be romantic, which is very occasional, then I will try my best.
Falakuma Palace.
I wanted something that had permanence, that had history, that had legacy, that had grandeur, and at the same time sort of looked out at a life that was beyond just two individuals.
The Taj Falakuma has this awesome balcony which overlooks the entire city of Hyderabad, and that's where he formally popped the question. Yeah, he didn't go down on one knee, but hey, that's good enough for me. I think that truly shows that he cared enough to make that effort, just so I'm happy, just so it makes me smile. Traces of you linger like a teardrop, fresh upon my heart, says for you, blaming like a red cloud, sounds upon the air.
She just has to look into my eyes to be able to tell how much I love her. I've never really been the kind of person who forces it on a day-to-day basis. And I love the fact that she understands that. I know that it causes some heartache from time to time. And I think the best way to say I love her is by apologizing for the kind of heartache or any kind of trouble that I may have put her through. And tell her that I'm always there for her, for good, evil, bad, for great times ahead. But I'm there to hold her hand for the entire journey ahead. Rock solid, rock solid.